So far, what we've done is called the recognizer task. We have a function match, which takes a pattern and a text, and that returns back a substring of text if it matches or none. And it's called a recognizer because we're recognizing whether the prefix of text is in the language defined by the pattern. There's a whole other task called the generator, in which we generate from a pattern the complete language defined by that pattern. So, for example, the pattern A or B sequenced with A or B, that defines a language of four different strings, AA, AB, BA, and BB. And we could define a function that takes a pattern and generates out that language. And that all seems fine. One problem, though, is if we have a language like A star, then the answer for that should be the empty string or A or AA or AAA and so on. And it's an infinite set. And so that's a problem. How are we going to represent this infinite set? Now, it's possible we could have a generator function that generates the items one at a time, and that's a pretty good interface. But instead, I'm going to have one where we say, let's limit the sizes of the strings we want. And if we say we want all strings up to n characters in length, then that's always going to be a finite set. And I'm going to take the compiler approach. So rather than write a function generate, I'm going to have the generator be compiled into the patterns. And so what we're going to write is a pattern, which is a compiled function, and we're going to apply that to a set of integers representing the possible range of lengths that we want to retrieve, and that's going to return a set of strings. And so, for example, if we define pattern to be A star, we did that appropriately, and then we asked for a pattern, and we gave it the sets 1, 2, 3, then that should return all strings which are derived from the pattern that have a length of 1, 2, or 3, and so that should be the set A, AA, and AAA. So now let's go ahead and implement this.